Hey there, in this video I'm gonna show you how to separate a song into voice and instrumental, so you can create a cover for a song or a remix, a karaoke version of a song or anything else you want. The only thing you're gonna need are Audacity, which you probably already have, and a plugin called OpenVinyl, which is gonna allow you to separate the music. So let's get started. Well, so first thing you gotta do is download Audacity if you don't have it. Make sure you click on this one though, because if you click on this one, the blue one, it's gonna download you a launcher, which you probably don't want. So the next, I've downloaded that, the next one would be downloading the OpenVinyl or OpenVinyl, however you pronounce that, add-on for Audacity. So you just click here, if you have Windows of course, and here if you have Mac. There is also a way to install it on Linux, but that's a little bit more complicated. I'm not gonna get into that in here. Once you have both things, you can install Audacity first, again, if you don't have it. This is a simple installation. It's just your typical next, 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 next. And I'm gonna click not to launch it, because now I'm gonna install, let me organize this. Now I'm gonna install the OpenVinyl plugin. Alright, next, and here it's gonna give you some options. It's gonna tell you if you want to download these other AI things. I would encourage you to play with them if you want. Honestly, except for this one, honestly, this music generation one is garbage. But something like whisper transcription could be useful if you want to try it, and noise suppression. As for this video, I'm just gonna focus on music separation model, the first one. That's the one that we want to separate music. I'm gonna leave all the other ones unchecked. Then next, and install. All right, so let's open Audacity. Let's go with Accept. I'm gonna close this. And if you go here to effects, you should have OpenVinyl and OpenVinyl. Well, it's not gonna show up because I don't have the song selected, but it should show up. If it doesn't show up for you, you gotta go to Edit, Preferences, and then go to Modules, and then scroll down and look for OpenVinyl. So you gotta make sure that it is enabled. If it wasn't enabled, just check enable, then okay, and then close Audacity and open it again. So I'm gonna drag in the music that I wanna separate the audio from. This is a song I generated with Suno AI because I wanted to avoid copyright, but it sounds so realistic that it's gonna work all the same. So let's play it for a little bit to have an idea how it sounds like first before separating it. In the shadows of the kitchen floor, a legend rises. Hear the roar. Tiny legs, but a heart so grand. The cockroach crusader takes a stand. The crumbs they scatter, the fridge light glows. Destiny calls where the trash can overflow. All right, that's enough. Pretty good. And well, that voice has a few effects applied to it, so it's gonna be certainly a tough one. Let's try and see what we get. So you can double click the whole thing double click the track to select the whole thing, and then you go to effect of environment, and then you click on music separation. And here you have the option to select two stems, which is just the instrumental and vocals, which is what I usually do. Or you can also separate by drum, bass, vocals and others, which can be pretty useful if you're a musician. I'm gonna leave it at 2. And here, if you have an Intel GPU, then I will recommend you to select GPU. If you don't, if you have a AMD or Nvidia GPU like me, then don't select it, it's actually gonna be slower. This is more optimized for Intel, unfortunately. And here in advanced, it's gonna give you an option to improve the quality, but it's gonna take longer. For example, if you put in 5, it's literally gonna take like 5 times as long, but it's gonna be better. But honestly, I wouldn't go much higher than that because it's not even worth it. You're not gonna notice differences and it's gonna take way longer. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it at 5 and apply. All right, so that took about a minute and a few seconds. So he's gonna leave you with the actual song at the top and then the two separated vocal and instruments. So let's, and you can see here in the name that it says instrumental and the other one says vocal, so you know which one is which. Let's isolate first the instrumental so you know how it sounds like. Well, this part is just instrumental anyway, so let's go to the part where it actually is singing to see how it separated the voice. That's not too bad. As I said before, it is an AI song, so it might have some quirks here and there that's not gonna sound as good as a real one, but usually it comes out better with a real singer and a real instrument. So let's do the same now with the vocals. In the shadows of the kitchen floor, a legend rises, hear the roar. Tiny legs, but a heart so grand. The cockroach crusader takes a stand. The crumbs they scatter, the fridge light glows. Destiny calls where the trash can overflow. And obviously it has some reverb because the original voice has some reverb, but that's something that you could edit out. But that's gonna be a problem with any program you use to separate vocals and instrumental. I guess it depends on the song you want to separate. And that was it. So I was also gonna include in the video another program that actually does better than Audacity at separating voice instrumentals from songs, but that program is a lot more complicated to use and it has some quirks that I gotta get into, so the video was gonna get too long. If you want me to cover that on another video, then just let me know down in the comments and I'll make sure to make a video on it too. If you found the video helpful, then don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you later.